Well, this time of year, you know, every year you're very excited about it if you're a college basketball coach, and this year's no different. They continue to be exciting, maybe even more exciting than the ones prior to. I enjoy it. I love the game. I'm happy with the team that we have. We're going to be a very young team. No seniors, three juniors, a bunch of sophomores, and a bunch of freshmen, nine new players. So it's going to take a little while to gel this team and get them all together, but I'm really excited about the potential that we have. And I know we were picked last in the conference, and so, you know, there's no place to go but up. But I told our team that, you know, we're tied for last right now, but we're also tied for first. You know, by the time conference games roll along, the majority of them after Christmas or at least into December, you know, with the schedule that we have, hopefully we'll be very much prepared for, you know, tough conference games and see what happens. Well, I think anytime you can play some extra games, it's great. And when you play some extra games against quality opponents on a neutral floor, I think that's fantastic. And obviously Tampa coming off, I think they were 33-2 last year or something. And, you know, we're going to play them right off the bat. They're ranked number 5. That's going to be a great challenge for us. But, you know, our players, you know, we've talked about it for a long time. We knew they were going to be ranked up there high. The rankings just came out on the 31st, but we knew they were going to top 5, top 10 for sure. But the rankings early in the rankings, you know, they're based on last year. And so this is an opportunity for a Minot State women's basketball team to go against a ranked team that's ranked in the top 5. And I don't know if they've ever beat them in the Division II era. I'm not sure if they have or not, but it's something for us to possibly get a program first. And so it's exciting for us. And when you play a team like that, you know, you really don't have anything to lose, because if they're really ranked number 5 and you're picked last in your conference, you know, it could be very tough. But I feel our players are really competitive and are playing well together. And, you know, one thing for sure is that we're going to work our tail off and give them a great fight. Well, I think, you know, you just try to find your team's identity initially. And we've had two scrimmages, which have helped us. The thing that I really like about this team is that I firmly believe we're taking 12 players, and I'm confident in all 12 players going in the game. I think that's going to be a huge asset for us, especially as we go into these three games in 3 days. It's going to be really brutal because, I mean, you can practice and you can practice hard, but nothing can you do that really simulates a game besides a game. And so they're going to be three really intense games. But I think with our depth that we have and not have to play as many minutes, I think that's going to be a huge advantage for us as we, you know, just try to learn about ourselves and, you know, who our key players are that can step up in games and who handles the pressure well. So it's going to be a lot of fun. It's great competition. Like I said, three extra games, so we love doing it. Well, I really expect good things from all of them. You know, we recruit them for a purpose, and as I mentioned earlier, you know, with 12 solid players that are traveling with us, I'm pretty excited about all of them, you know, and I expect all of them to do certain things. And, you know, it's a very different group. We have quite a few three-point shooters, and, you know, it's different. You have three-point shooters in practice and in the fall, but, you know, who's going to step up during the games and who's going to have a solid shooting percentage and be a factor? You know, you hope most of them will, but, you know, time will tell on that. But, you know, we have some people that come off the bench that can be a threat on defense, you know, really getting after it, which we have starters that play that way, and so we have some subs coming in there. We have some depth coming in, you know, inside. So I'm really excited, you know, to see. But I really do expect about all of them to step up and do some good things for us. All right. I coached junior college for 14 years, and it was so obvious the difference between a freshman to a sophomore. You know, I don't think there's any other year, you know, junior to senior, sophomore to junior, whatever, that you see as much improvement as that freshman to sophomore year, because you finally get college basketball under your belt, and you know, you learn the ins and outs, and you find out how physical it is. So I'm extremely happy with our sophomores this year that put in a lot of time last year in minutes and in hard work, and in the spring they worked hard, and so I'm really excited about that. You know, our starting lineup is probably gonna be 4 sophomores and a junior. And so each of them, Emma Mogan, you know, obviously being the junior, she's a great leader for us, been in our program with me as a coach for 3 years. But V, Lo, Jamie, Emily, those 4 are really, really solid players. And I'm just pleasantly pleased at how well they are and how well they are playing this year. And another thing about this team and those 4 included is that I believe they really want it. You know, they want to be a good basketball team. They work hard at practice. They take coaching very well. Their leadership is extremely well. V and Emma being named captains, but our players are receptive to them too. You know, and sometimes you know they'll get after them a little bit, but everybody knows that we talked about, you know, yeah, we're trying to do this to make you better, make our team better. So far the chemistry has been really well in taking, you know, constructive criticism also. Well, that's also to be determined, but I really like what you said, because hopefully we'll a little bit of everything, you know, and that's how you become a really good basketball team, not to be one-dimensional, but you know, and we teach and we preach a lot on take what the defense gives you, and obviously they can't take everything away from you, or you know, a great team would hold people scoreless and shut out, and that doesn't happen in basketball, of course. So we just want to take what the defense gives us, but I really feel we have a higher number of three-point shooters, which is going to help. Inside, I think we have a pretty good presence in there. If you know, if they pressure the outside, we can get it inside. And defense will definitely be there. You know, that's going to be one of our trademarks. And always, as a coach here, you know, I will have a good, solid defensive team that works extremely hard. But I like the way that we're pretty much well-rounded in different areas. And as I said, you know, to be determined. But I'm pretty confident that we're going to be well-rounded inside and out offensively and solid defensively. I would say if there was a weakness right now, you know, it might be. It's hard to teach them how important it is to rebound when they're practicing against each other, because you're going to go against some really good rebounding teams that block out or that crash the boards hard. And so that's something that I think that could possess a problem for us. We have a couple that really go hard all the time, but we have to make sure we have five people going on defense, going for the boards, and then four on offense with one safety. So if there's anything that I'm a little bit concerned about, that may be it. Yeah, I think it kind of surprised our players, you know, being ranked last, because if you look at the standings last year and would have ranked them, you know, this year, the way they're going to get in the conference tournament, we'd have been in the conference tournament. We were ahead of three or four teams. And so to get popped down to the bottom after beating those teams in the standings, it kind of hit them a little bit. But that's fine. You know, it's preseason. It's motivation for them if they want to use it for that. But that's fine. You know, it all matters what goes throughout the season, where you end up. But it's nice to use it as a motivational tool. But, you know, we have an extremely tough non-conference schedule, playing 31 games instead of 26. I think it's an added bonus, and hopefully we can get some wins out of there. We haven't mentioned about being on the road Warriors yet, but, you know, we're on the road, I think, 9 of our first 10 games, so that's going to be difficult. But our goal and my goal here is that we're trying to develop a championship mentality, and we're trying to be able to be a tough team, and we're trying to obviously get to the conference tournament, which we haven't yet since I've been here, but the ultimate goal is getting to the NCAA tournament. And I feel this is the way you do it. You go out and you play the toughest teams on the road, you know, and obviously some on a neutral court, which is tough. I mean, if you don't want to go against a great team on a neutral floor, then there's something wrong with you. You know, you want to have a great shot at them on a neutral floor, and so you schedule them like that. So we're excited about the extra games. We're excited about the competition. And the main thing is that, you know, it is great competition, and games are going to be tough on the road to win. And it's just a matter of making sure that, you know, our players stay confident if we go through a couple of bumps here in these early season games, that, you know, that they realize we're playing quality opponents and we're going to do nothing but get better by playing them.